Christian Fellowship. Now, folks, we were in Grand Junction, Colorado.
Amen.
John Carson Show.
This morning. And came through beautiful scenery. Red rocks. Have you ever seen those red rocks? And all that? You ever seen all that? Of course you have. Utah, down into a little bit of Arizona, and finally, we hit Henderson. And we're so happy to be here. How many have never been to Henderson? All right. Well, it's our privilege to be here. And actually, we started last Saturday. and we were in the Phoenix area for Sunday, and then four services and concerts in Colorado. And here tonight and tomorrow we head back to campus, and Sunday morning we're at Santa Clarita Baptist Church, and Sunday night we're at Grace Community Church. And these students, we are having an absolute thrill. Amen?
Amen.
And I didn't tell them to say that. I want to say this. Now, how many of you actually, a week ago tonight, this very night, at this very time, how many of you graduated from master's? From a couple of our students, Russell Vitrip and Angelina Korovki, and they both graduated last Friday, and they have quite the stories to tell you about their life and what the Lord is doing in their life. Russell.
Well, first of all, thank you so much for having us here. My name is Russell, this is Angelina, and we want to share just a little bit about what God has done in our lives. So, to give a little bit of backstory about my time at Masters, I came as a freshman music major, music education, and I wanted to obviously then pursue music and make it a lifetime job, right? A lifetime vocation. And so I was in the chorale, and it's so much fun being able to sing with these guys, such an honor. So I loved every minute of it. And so we're coming to the end of the year, and we're going to Albania for our chorale tour that year. And I'm so excited. I am so pumped to go to Albania. The farthest I've ever been away is like Canada. So Albania feels a little farther, but yeah. I was so excited. But those last couple weeks, I started to get sick. I got a cough. And I'm like, I can't go to Albania with a cough. There's no way, right? So I go to the doctor. I get an antibiotic. Doesn't really do anything. Okay. Gets a little worse. I go again. Nope, doesn't really do anything. Finally, I go the third time on the very last day of the semester, right before we're going to Albania, and they say, you know what, let's run some blood tests, let's do some blood work. So they do the blood tests, and they get back to me, and they say, you need to go get a blood transfusion and a bone marrow biopsy as soon as possible. And if you don't know what a bone marrow biopsy is, that's awesome, because it is something, I will tell you. These guys, yeah, they've heard that a lot. But so I fly home, and I'm admitted into the hospital. And a couple days later, probably like 2 days, not long at all, the doctor comes in and he says, we've had a positive diagnosis for what's going on. And he proceeds to tell me that I had cancer, had leukemia. And so this wasn't quite what I was expecting, you know, believe it or not, right? I wasn't quite expecting to go to the hospital at this time. My heart was set on Albania, and my heart was set on singing with these guys and pursuing music and, you know, and ministering in that way. I thought that was my path in life. I had it all planned out. But God had different plans, right? So 3.5 years later of treatment, praise the Lord, now I'm cancer-free.
Amen. Amen.
You have a lot of time to sit around and think during 3.5 years, don't you? At least I did. I wasn't really doing much, you know, just, you know, back and forth, hospital, home. But you learn a lot in that time, and God teaches you a lot through those hard trials. And so one of the main things I learned was that we have our plans, but God has His plans.
Amen. Right?
That's right.
And His plans are so much better than our plans could ever be.
Amen.
So I came back to Masters. Finally, I feel like after a couple years as a pre-med major, which was a huge change for music, but I feel God was calling me in that direction. Something I want to just encourage all of you with is to don't... I didn't expect this, obviously, but... And I didn't handle it as well as I could have, obviously. God is so gracious in that He came and He pulled me closer to Him, but... If you go through a trial, and I know many of us have, and all of us are going to, Jesus guarantees that. But even so, God is faithful. God is so good to us. God is strong enough to get us through even our toughest trials, even though we think they're so hard. Look at what he created. Look at what he made around us. He is so powerful and so faithful to get us through these things. So that's my encouragement to you tonight.
Shalom, everyone. Can you say shalom?
Shalom.
You speak Hebrew now? My name is Angelina. I'm from Israel. And I started my education at the Master's University in 2016. And I just graduated on Friday. It took me a little bit longer. But on the last day of my first semester, I was involved in a car accident, after which I had traumatic brain injury, half my body was paralyzed, I had many broken bones, I had a very serious surgery, I was in pain for several months, and I had to learn again how to walk, dress myself, talk better, and just do everyday things. I had to go through several therapies, and I had to go back home and leave Masters, which was my dream for many years. And during this time of rehabilitation, I was very depressed. I was still smiling to people, and I was kind to them and encouraging and saying that I'm doing so well, everything is fine. But inside, I was in such a dark place, such very deep, dark waters. And I would sometimes ask, God, what is my life? I don't think I can go further anymore. But one verse would come to my mind. When you go through deep waters, I will help you. I was also asking God, God, do you love me? Do you even love me? And until today, I regret so much for just even thinking about it. Because God loves you so, so much. He sent his only son to die for you. It's, what a love. It's amazing. And can it be? It's just amazing. And also, if you go through trials, it doesn't mean that God does not love you. Because he himself, Jesus, said that in this life you will have troubles. However, you should also remember his words when he left the earth. He said, I am with you always. It means that through every trial, every pain, every dark night, he's there with you. And he supports you with his fatherly love. He's your Abba Father.
Amen.
And he just holds his children with his eternal life. And he leads them through every storm in this life. And the next song reminds us that God is with us always. And he says, cry no more.
Where we linger in this darkness. help me to pray, tell me my Lord done pass his way.
He's a coward, he's a liar.
Hallelujah, Lord.
Father, thank you again for just a privilege, Lord. What an honor it is. Even to get a phone call from Dr. Blue was just amazing to talk to him and for him even to consider us. We're so grateful for that. We ask you to may bless this offering, dear Father, that you'd use it for your glory. And we ask now you may bless this time that we have together.
pray, we ask this in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And playing violin is Lenore Lee. At the piano is Aubrey Church. And they're going to play a little Bazzini. And and then I have to do an SAT test. I had no idea what it was.
When I found out what it was, I didn't want to do it. It was because it was really expensive, and that was a joke. It was expensive, and I needed to go to Mexico City and many other different places, and we were going to Canada that same year, so it was really, really hard for me to do it financially. And I just couldn't do it. I forgot about it, my parents forgot about it, and the Lord didn't forget about it. A few months later, COVID strikes, and I get an email saying, because there's COVID, the SAT has been waived, and you're accepted to the Massachusetts University. So I was like, this is awesome. So I go to my mom, I tell her, Mom, I'm going to the Massachusetts University, and she tells me, no way, Jose. Scholarships. And I needed scholarships, so I started praying to the Lord, and I said, you know what? Lord, if you want me there, it is well with my soul. That's the next hymn we're going to sing. And that's what came to my mind. You know, if God wants me there, praise the Lord. If he doesn't want me there, it is well with my soul. Yes. And so I applied for the embassy, and we couldn't. 1 week we're leaving. We just couldn't do it. They canceled it because of COVID. So my father said, you know, we're going to Canada, so you can apply there in Canada, and you'll get your visa there. So I said, okay, that's good. First day on the road, the trailer breaks down. And I said, it is well with my soul, Lord. And you know, we fixed it the old Mexican way with some duct tape, and we kept on going. And we get to Canada, and we have to quarantine. And the quarantine ended August 16th, and I needed to be at Master's August 21st. And I still needed my student visa. There were so many things on the wrist. So I was, Lord, again, if it's your will, it is well with my soul. If it's not your will, it is well with my soul. So I applied, and they said, you got your appointment December 20th, 2020. And I said, it is well with my soul. And I told my admissions counselor. My admissions counselor sent me an email. I sent it to the embassy. They reply the next day and say, hey, we moved it to August 17th, one day after quarantine ends. So I was, it is really well with my soul right now. So I go to Masters, I get my visa, everything works out, and I arrived on August 21st, I need to be there at 5, and I arrived August 21st, 5:55 p.m. You know, this taught me something really, really important. To trust the Lord always. He is faithful to those that trust him and are willing to say, it is well with my soul. Yeah. So if you're passing through some hard times, trust the Lord and say, it is well with my soul.
the hymn story. If you don't know the hymn story behind it, that's pretty good. Go home tonight and look it up online. I mean, imagine being a dad, looking into the Atlantic Ocean where your four daughters are in a watery grave. You say, with peace like a river attending by and sorrows like sea billows roll. Whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say.
It is well with my soul.
Now, we have a song called His Mercy is More. It's in your program. And our students are going to come up. And you're going to stand. Let's all stand. And they're gonna get in between all of you. And we're going to have a great choir. While they're doing that, introduce yourself.
His mercy is more.
many know Amazing Grace?
Oh, yeah.
Let's sing it together. Now, please, praise the Lord, sing it. If you know the melody, sing it. Here we are.
Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but
liberal arts school in, well, let's see if you guys know. Does anyone know what
That, what city? There's two cities. I don't even know what city the Masters University is in. If you know, can you raise your hand?
Santa Clarita, yes.
Well done. Okay, another quiz question. This is a little bit harder, but does anyone know what our sports, what is it called? Mascot is. Oh, okay, over there in the white.
Mustang.
Yes!
Woohoo!
Woo! Well done. So the Masters University is in Santa Clarita, California, and we are the Mustangs, so I'm proud. And we are a liberal arts university of about 1,000 on campus, but with our online programs, we add up to about 2,000 students. So I want to introduce you to a few of the different majors in the Chorale. How many of you guys are majors other than music? Nice! Other than music, how many of you are music majors? How many of you guys are Bible majors?
Hey.
Nice. So our Bible majors are taught by faculty who all agree to the same doctrinal statement. And they all hold to the inerrancy of Scripture.
Amen.
And the six-day creation, which we're only among four or five other universities across the nation who hold to that. What's really exciting is our other majors, the faculty also hold to that. And all of our different majors get a minor in Bible just from the general classes that they take. How many business majors do we have?
Woohoo!
Nice. So our business school actually ranks in the top 7% of business schools nationwide. And then our pre-med, do we have any pre-med people?
Woo!
Nice. They have a 95% acceptance rate to the graduate school.
Amen.
Wow. In all things, the Masters University stands for Christ and Scripture. And some great things you get is a faculty that's unified and also a student-teacher ratio of 11 to 1.
Wow.
So that you can really dial in on your personal goals and have faculty that know you personally. So I wanted to help over this tour get you guys a little bit more connected about the university at large. So if you are someone interested in any of our programs, we have online master's programs, and we have undergrad programs on our campus. I have stickers for you if you fill out an inquiry card. I also wanted to tell you a little bit more about our school of music, since we are the Chorale. Our school of music has several different ensembles. We have the chorales you've heard tonight, and you will continue to hear. We have the University Singers, which is a large choir and a university orchestra, amongst other ensembles. And they've been busy this semester making a new album. So if you look in your program, you can see there's an album that says It Is Well. It's based on the song that you just heard. And we are offering it to you, individuals, as part of our special pre-order tour option. You are among the first people to hear about this. So if you would like to receive, yeah, we can give a hand for that. If you would like to receive this album hot off the presses into your email inbox, all I need you to do is to fill out the card on the back. Any donation, $10 or above, will get you that free CD. And there's several options. There's 250, 500, other, and you can put a number and then as many zeros as you would like. Any number of zeros. So if you would like to receive that, you can fill that out tonight and get that to me in the back. We also have our email list, Friends of Music email, where we'd love to stay connected with you and let you know next time we're in Henderson, Nevada, or anywhere else in the country, or in Santa Clarita, California. So that's a little bit about the school. I hope you enjoy hearing the rest of the... Okay, let's talk about school music a little bit more, because it's our favorite school. So our seniors, raise your hand if you're a senior in the School of Music. These guys graduated last Friday. And they take a standardized test that all music majors across the nation take. And they scored, can we get a drum roll please? In the 90th percentile nationwide. Very exciting. And it's a really encouraging thing that even though we are a small university tucked away in Santa Clarita, California, these students are performing very well academically. And they're not just doing it for themselves, they're doing it for the Lord. So that's what the Master's University is all about, excellence for Christ and for Scripture. So if you have more questions, please find me in the back and enjoy the rest of the concert.
Accepted Christ back then, but for a long time my faith was just that of a child, even in pushing middle school and high school years. Early in my life, God had some medical challenges in store for me, and when I was 11 years old, I had a brain surgery. So following that, the symptoms should have all been gone, the problem should have been fixed, but within 6 months, the symptoms had returned. And the doctors who had just seen us said that you're crazy and there's nothing wrong with you, you're just making this up. So that formed a lot of bitterness and anger in my heart that I held on to and tried to hold on to for a long, long time. Pushing forward for a bit, middle school and high school, I was very much an angry child, though I knew all the answers to the Bible, so I was a hypocrite. I would raise my hand and say that Jesus is the answer for everything, and then turn around and just hold grudges and lash out at people that I cared about. I came to Masters in fall 2018, and that is when I hit my lowest point in the semester, or in my life. The pain had been going on for 8 years, all the stuff that the brain surgery should have fixed, and I was angry at everyone for any reason I could think of, and usually I made up my own reasons. I barely made it through the semester, and after I did, I went on the Turkey and Greece study tour, which is offered every few years by the Masters University, where you get to go to Turkey and Greece and walk through Paul's missionary journeys, and it is fantastic time. I love seeing the sights, but I would complain about hearing things here and there and just always have just this attitude of bitterness. Someone called me out on it, took me a few days, but then I finally realized what I was doing. And that's when I repented. We were in Ephesus, and I remember seeing the road into this ancient ruins that are very nicely preserved, where Paul probably walked down that road to get to the church there. And the Bible suddenly felt more real than it ever had before, and I am so, so grateful to the Lord and to my friends at Masters for calling me out and for allowing me to repent to God. Following that trip, I come back home, and we got a call from our doctor friend who said that, yes, what you had can come back. You're not crazy, which is the first time I've heard those words. So they found that there was two holes near my brain that were leaking spinal fluid for 8 years. This fluid was pooling in my skull and just in the back of my neck up here. And it wasn't until I was in surgery that they found that all that fluid had calcified, turned to bone. So they had to drill through to get to the holes, and then they finally patched it up. And that day was the biggest relief of pain that I'd ever felt. No pressure in my head, no pain in my head. And I had an attitude of gratefulness to the Lord for this, so I praise the Lord for that. Found out afterwards that the entire team of medical staff, or rather the vast majority of them, were Christians, and they were praying for me through the surgery, which was more of a blessing than I ever could have had. God has done so many great things in my life, and I wanted to share with you Psalm 37:4, delight yourself in the Lord, and he'll give you the desires of your heart. Not the desires of your broken heart that is evil and wicked, but when you are delighting yourself in the Lord, your desires will be his desires.
Amen.
And something that Charles Wesley, who wrote the next hymn, And Can It Be, surely found out when he went about preaching all throughout the town, but he didn't get it from his head to his heart. And when he finally did, he said, can it be that I am saved? Can it be that God died for me?
Amen.
Be that I should be.
Thank you. He will hold me fast. How many know the song by Matt Berger?
He will hold me fast. You don't know that? Okay, we're going to teach you.
I could never
proclaim his grace and glory.
One of the greatest tenors that you know.
Yes, but you've designed and coached and brought these magnificent people here, and here's what we're going to do for you. For your surprise, John MacArthur, next month, we're buying a ranch in Colorado, which you now know on Highway 70, and when we finish the Shepherd's Conference, John MacArthur will invite in those 4,500 pastors from 60 nations to be his guests at our ranch. They'll have the best R&R they've ever had in their life.
Amen.
You guys are going to be our guests, and we'll fly you all over the world. And we'll do a good changes to you.
Amen.
That comes from the former first trumpeter of the city of Los Angeles 76 years ago.
We got to talk. That's you.
Not me, that is I. Over and over, because I've done these in 112 countries. We're happy to have you here. You should tell us more about that lovely Chinese violinist.
All right, folks. One of the best known hymns and a favorite hymn. Raise your hand if you have a favorite hymn. Amazing Grace. Amazing Grace. Anybody over here? In the back.
Amazing Grace.
Amazing Grace. Who? I'm sorry, what'd you say?
Hallelujah Chorus.
Oh, the Hallelujah Chorus. You want to hear the Messiah from the Handel? You want to hear that one? No. Oh, that's good. Anybody over here? Yes. I was waiting for that.
Yeah.
It's right here.
Oh, yes.
How old are you?
19.
Wow. Now that blesses my heart. Amen. To be 19 years old and a favorite hymn is the Old Rugged Cross. Amen. On a hill. Okay, we've got to keep going. It's 8:32. And I know some of you are usually in bed by 9 o'clock. Okay.
Sing
How
on,
great
brother.
Thou art. And then Pastor Dan, you're going to say a word.
You just keep
right?
singing, brother.
And can we... Okay, I don't know how we're going to do this, but we're going to. We're going to... This gentleman right there. Just make sure that we can walk back there. It's your responsibility. And we're going to wrap around the room and we're going to say... And we're going to wrap around the room and do a final choral benediction after Pastor Daniel has a word. Folks, really, really, we should be applauding them all the preparation.
Thank you.
His son not sparing, sent him to die. I scarce can take it in.
And sings my soul how great thou art,
that on the cross my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died. Henderson, and first time for many of them to be here, and we are just so grateful that
they can come and bless us. We pray that you'd help us, Father, to be a blessing to them. And Lord, we're just so thankful for your love and your mercy. And we're just so grateful for Dr. Plue and Pam and all that are here, dear Father. We are grateful. Lord, we look forward to the day that we'll forever be singing to you praises and filled with your joy. I pray that you would help us to live our lives in this way, lives of praise and thanksgiving. Father, we thank you most of all for sending our Savior, our Lord Jesus Christ, into this world. Around 2,000 years ago, we thank you, Father, that you sent him into this world as a Lamb of God to come and to die a substitutionary death for sinners, dear Father. We're so thankful for that. And Lord, he was taken and he was put in the grave, and on the third day he rose again.
Amen.
And now, Father, today people are being saved and forgiven of their sin because of Jesus Christ, our Savior and our Lord.
That's right.
We just want to thank you and praise you most of all for our Savior. Bless us now, Father, we pray as we fellowship, and we ask that you may bless the rest of our evening. And Lord, keep us all safe. We beseech you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
our bus drivers. Woo-hoo! James Badger drove something like 520 miles today. And he came to our concert. Encourage one another.
Yes, sir.